Are you sure about that?
That's a bear tune, that is. The barest tune. Hey guys, welcome back. Jimmy here for the third time today. Is that my professional stream hall? Yes. Yes, it is. I'm not actually sure if that's going to play again. I don't think it does. Hello, everybody. We did part... I need to make this bigger. We did part whatever it was earlier, part one of this. unfortunately, like, there was a lot of questions I couldn't get through them all at once, so we're going to do some more now. That one? How the bloody hell do I even do this? No, it's controlling this. Oh, yeah. There you go. Oh, no, we've gone too far. And now I've lost my fucking place. I know our last question was by DM. Oh, hello, Tasty. Thank you for the $10, mate. Thank you for being such an inspiration to me. You're a great person to watch and interact with. You even inspire me to do sim racing. I wish you the best of luck and success. Please never change. Thank you, man. That's a really kind thing to say to me. Hope you are having a good day, man. Thank you. I'd like to kiss you more often because you're such a tease, Aero. That's why. Right. We don't actually have that many questions left, but what I'm going to do is, after we've done this, is I'm going to open up the questions just to general. We'll do it and we'll do chat, and then that'll be it. It's not going to be long, going to be about an hour or so this stream, but I wanted to finish it off because if people have taken the time to ask me questions, then I should take the time to answer them. That's only the normal thing to do. I guess we'll start here because Jimmy doesn't really have a question here. He just says, I have no question. Just say, you're the best car game... the best... reading. The best car games channel. Continuous like that. I will try, Jimmy. I will try. F you too, David. F you. Josh Ladd says, what do I do for a living? I do YouTube for a living. Yes. I did, mister. Thank you. And by the way, I did get the other bit you sent through, so thank you for that, mate. For a living, I'm a YouTuber. Full-time. I'm a streamer, cam whore, whatever the hell you want to call me, and I'm really proud to say that. So, it's good. Joe Atkins asks, what's my favourite UK track? Probably Brand Snatch, I think. Do I want his virginity? Oh, yeah. His weeing in his butt virginity, as he's so keen on. Bless him. No. Yeah, probably Brands Hatch. I really like Brands Hatch, especially the GP layout. Not quite as much as Gamer Muscle likes Brands Hatch, but I like Brands Hatch a lot. It's just great. All right, Jimski 10. All right, Alex. Clark says, why haven't I admitted that BMW are superior yet? Because they're not. Hopefully we'll do some British GT BTCC so we can meet and definitely not race my hybrid boy against the Turbo MX-5. Mate, once the Turbo MX-5 has got its 300 brake horsepower engine plus, you ain't got a chance, man. I don't care how much of a hybrid you got. LS asked, that's hard to say, will this be? Any chance of a Pikes Peak hill climb series, Jimmo? Probably not, but I will do some more Pikes Peak stuff. Oh, I can't. Some more Pikes Peak stuff, because I do like doing Pikes Peak. It's a unique challenge. I just wish there were more cars to drive on. Although I know that Dirt has that mod that you can drive any car on any circuit, so I would take that. Drift Noob saying, my favourite F1 car. Mine is the Williams FW18. That's a hard one. Probably one of the 99 Jordans, maybe. Well, the thing is, though, I really like that era of F1. The pre-98 when they were wide, they look really cool, especially the Prost as well. Livery wise, probably a Jordan or a Shadow. In terms of how it looked, I probably agree with your Williams, actually. Really nice looking cars. Benelou, I can't say that, I'm sorry, mate. I am French, so sorry for my English. That's okay, I'll let you off. I learned English with your videos and got my language degree thanks to you. Oh my god, how are you speaking? Please, do you speak with a really pronounced lisp? thank you me for two saying, why aren't you answering with your wheel? There you go. And Benelou asks, why don't I ask organize my own sim racing championship? I sort of answered this earlier, but I'll go over it again. It's just a lot of work and I don't really have the time. I would be willing to race in a series that someone made on my behalf, and then I raced it and streamed it, etc. But I just don't have time for the admin work, frankly. I don't have the time for it. I can't do it, so that's why I'm afraid. Tire Tear asks, There was a donation bar for the FC3S, and it disappeared a few in the last few streams. Will you buy an FC3S or project cancelled? There's a lot of people who sort of asked around that about that, and I want to clarify. I guess project is cancelled, yes. I'm sorry that I wasn't clear with that. I did sort of mention on a couple of streams that it was going to be too expensive to really do that realistically, and to be able to have a Turbo MX-5 and an RX-7 at the same time. So I figured what I'd do is I put pretty much all that money that came from that, I've put it into the MX-5, and it's going to be a bigger beast. Excuse me. That's the idea. We'll make a big beast out of the MX-5 instead, because over here it's like 10 grand to buy an FC, not even an FC3S, and there's no guarantee that it'll work. So it's just not worth the money. Will there be any vlogs for the Turbo MX-5? Yes, there will be. Coming up soon. Coming up soon. Not really a question from GD there, but thank you for the nice comments, man. Dream F1 car. I guess I've already gone over that, but I would love to have like an old 97 F1 car just sitting on the drive. It would be rad. Solstice League, no. Please drink better lager. Nah. Hope you had the engine mounts done. They are going to be done at the end of this month. This music's kind of foreboding, isn't it? Joe asked, how are you doing personally? I know this is real broad, not rather private, but I know you talked about some struggles you had before or might still do. Well, I think it might be inspiring to hear how or if things have changed. I don't mind talking about it, Joe. I was saying that I still have issues. I still have very bad days where I'm unable really to do anything apart from lay in bed and complain. But I also have good days, and for me it's about maximising the good days where I'm able to get up and be happy Jimmer, as opposed to sort of like grumpy boy. But there are, as I said earlier, there are more good days than bad days at the moment, so I guess it's a good thing. It's a good thing. Guys, I'm seeing some questions in chat. I will answer them after I have done these ones. There aren't that too many of these left. But yeah, Joe, I hope that answers your question. Christian asks, what kind of advice can you give someone who is just starting to get into sim racing? Find something that you enjoy, I guess. Find a car and track and drive it a lot. Just get used to driving. Get used to the idea of driving with the feedback or lack of feedback you get from a full seatbelt wheel compared to a real car. I think that's the important thing. Year. Nick says, I enjoy watching you race and how well you drive, and you're a nice guy too. No matter how I try, I don't have the car control into out the corners like you do. So what is the best tip you can give us to control the car in and out of corners, assuming we're trying to take the correct line? Be slow, Nick. Don't rush it. If you're trying to take the correct line, make sure you know the line firstly. Go round and in top gear at 70 miles per hour or so, and just be nice and chill and make sure you've got the right line. Then once you understand the line better, that's when you start pushing it. Now, I guess like the old saying is slow in, fast out. Be slow into the corner and focus on your exit, which is always a good thing. Which is why I don't really teach people that much, because I'm sort of having an accident in and then drifting out. it's not very composed at all. But I'd say that would be the good idea. Just be slow. Don't rush it. Minesco says, so sad that Lenny Face is already gone. Lenny Face has never gone, man. They'll always be here. Fernando de Silva says, what advice would you give to someone who's starting a sim racing games focused channel? I guess that's a YouTube question. Do it because you like it, Fernando, and because you're enjoying it. Don't do it to try and chase numbers, etc. And that sounds like really stupid coming from someone who, you know, who's now a professional, I suppose. But when I started, like, no one really watched me. No one was really interested in what I was doing. But I did it anyway because I enjoyed it. And eventually I spammed people enough that they felt sorry for me and clicked the videos. So, I say that. Do it because you like it. And don't be offended if you don't get any views at the start, because they come eventually. Unlike my ex-wife. Mr. Premium says, I found you just a couple of weeks ago, and one day after that I bought a set of cores from loving it so far. Awesome, man. Hope you are enjoying it. Good to hear that. My question is how you got interested in motorsport and what racing series is your favourite. I sort of answered a motorsport question before, basically with my dad when I was very young. My favourite racing series is probably the WEC because it's just really interesting to watch. No wives. What? Sorry. Karen asks, after saying congrats, thank you, Cameron. Always wanted to know, how did you get into sim racing? What is your favourite car to drive, real life or sim? And do you plan on racing in real life? My favourite car to drive in real life is my car, my MX-5. I love it. Even though it's a shitbox and it's a little bit scary and a little bit rickety, it's just so fun. And I got into sim racing basically just by going through YouTube videos of R-Factor mods and wanting to drive the really cool the Formula, like the old Formula One mods that were from the 90s and 91 that just do not exist on the console. So I did that. George asked, what happened to GT Sport Le Mayo? Hey! Nothing happened to it. It still works. I don't know. I haven't taken it down. I just got bored of it. I get bored of a lot of games quite quickly. I try and keep myself entertained, and usually it's only like serious sim racing that keeps me entertained, so yeah. What's that? Stargas says, what is the song in this video called? It is called Deja Vu. No, it's not. It's called Running in the 80s by Magnavox. Good song. It's also my outro. What VR am I using? I answered that in the last video, but I'll say it again. Oculus Rift CV1. Ah. Sorry, this is not attractive. Okay. I really like the CV1. It's just a little bit, the res is a bit low. I'm looking forward to whatever next gen of VR looks like. Deprez asks, what's my favourite sim? And two, what car do you love driving the most? I'll take that as in the sim, and now it's the R18 in iRacing because it's just so fucking rad. And my favourite sim is Mario Kart 8. I don't really have one. It's a real answer to that question. Jose Macuella, I'm ruining your name, asks, what advice will you give to people who have never tried sim racing but got a brand new wheel and would love to start? Take it slow. Don't feel bad if you're not fast. Remember my first experience sim racing was against Bailey, pretty much. That was a humbling experience. Going from being the hot boy on Gran Turismo 5 to being 2 seconds a lap off Bailey was pretty sad. But you get there. You get there eventually and you find your place. But yeah, that's what I'd say. Take it slow. What does my family think about what you do? They don't really understand, to be honest. They don't really understand what I do. Matt sort of has a better idea than the rest of them, but my mum has no idea. Every now and then I tell my mum, like, oh, mum, I'm going to Denmark, like, for work. And she's like, oh, that's nice. I'm like, okay. But she doesn't really understand better. Why sim racing and not an FPS? I don't really like shooters that much. I'm not really into that. I like racing because I like racing in real life. I don't like guns in real life, so I don't like shooters, you know? It's sort of a bit like that. And I used to play Planet Side 2 a bit. That was fun. But that's about it. But how I got into racing games in general is when I was... I got a PS1, I think, when I was about 4 or 5 years old. And I had a demo of F1... It's just called Formula 1, but the F1 95 season was sort of... predecessor to F1 97. There never was an F1 96. And I played that demo so many times, lapping around. I think it was a 3-lap race around Nürburgring GP circuit, or 5-lap race actually. And I'd do it again and again and again and again and again. And then I got F1 97 when I was. It was a really nice moment. It's one of my favourite memories when I was sitting down. I had chicken pox, and because I was a really ill child, chicken pox was awful for me. Like, I had to go to the hospital a couple of times. But I was lying down on the sofa feeling pretty sorry for myself, and my mum came in with like a bag of pick and mix from Woolworths. Woolworths, I can't really say that. It's an old department store, it doesn't exist here in the UK. And I was like, oh my god, pick and mix, this is so cool, because I was never allowed pick and mix because of being ill, etc. I was like, I had very low tolerances to a lot of things, very sensitive, so I wasn't really allowed sweets that much. I was like, oh wow, cool, I get some sweets, this is the best day. And then inside the packet of Haribo, the pick and mix packet, was a copy of Tekken 2, which I probably shouldn't have had, and F1 97. It was like the coolest memory I have. Like, I was so happy because the bags were opaque, so I couldn't see through it. So it took me to like looking at it and be like, oh wow. And that was like the best. That was the best. And like I smile about it now because of how happy I was. It's a really nice memory. Really, really nice memory. Oh. Nintendo 64! I was that kid. How old am I? I'm 26. I've always been around, it was around like 10 years ago. Mr. Too Good at Racing Games, you've got to teach him, man. He says, I'm a new sub, came from Super GT when he tipped off. Your videos are awesome. My question is, can I play Forza with you? I don't play Forza too much, Mr. Too Good at Racing Games. But if I do, you're more than welcome. I do have Forza 7 somewhere. But I haven't got it right now. Turka saying, which punt you've experienced got you the most mad? Jimmy Rage Quit. I wonder if this comes up. There it is.
You're in the middle.
Oh my god, the guy diving up the inside nearly took us all out.
This is the punt that made me the most mad.
I just grazed that guy on the way past.
Because I had pace to be really fast here. I remember I was really fast.
That was a bit dangerous, Florin.
And I was like, oh, I can do really well in this race. And then...
God, the BMW threw down the first lap. It's just storming through there.
Go left. Oh, you can't see it.
What the fuck was that?
But basically, like, let me just show you the throw. Oh no, you can't see any of it. I've put everything right in the way.
The BMW threw down the first lap. It's just storming through there. Go left, go
left. Is that my back in the Twitch days? Look at that fucking face! Look at that face! Oh my god. Angry. but yeah, that's the one that made me the most angry. 100% that one. That was not a good, not a good time. Not a good time to have. That my disappointment. Yeah, young Jimmer. I was like 20, 23 then. But I hope that answers your question, Turka. Kibik asks, how much time do you need to set out for a stream? I can probably do it in about 10 minutes, but I like to give myself about half an hour just to make sure everything's in the right place, make sure all the audio's fine, make sure all my controls work in the game, etc. So I usually go about half an hour or so. The PS2 one used to take a lot longer because of the capture card, but I ended up getting that down to being even quicker as well. But usually the first time I do something new, it would take me hours to set up a stream. Like when I first did my first Gran Turismo 3 stream, it took me about 3 hours to get it all set up properly because of the delay of the capture card. But that doesn't take it long anymore. It's about half an hour, Kibik. Thank you for the question, man. Mickey D says, I recently saw your video about how 2016 was one of the worst years of your life. You seem a lot better compared to that time, so I wanted to ask for any advice for someone in a similar position. I am not doing good at the moment, I could do with the encouragement. Thanks for being awesome and taking my mind off things for a couple of hours a day. Well, I'm sorry, Mickey, I'm sorry you're not feeling too good at the moment, man. I know it's awful, I've been there, I am still sort of there. And just know that you always have somewhere to come and talk if you want. We have a Discord channel, which is in the description, which is below. Just click that, come say hello, come and speak to us. We'll take your mind off things if you want someone to talk to. But basically, Mickey, I just dedicated myself to like doing YouTube. I threw myself at it. I didn't really think I was going to get anywhere, but I did it anyway. I said to myself, if I can make a video a day, then that is me being productive and I can justify my existence. I know it sounds quite dramatic, but that's how I was at the time. And I don't quite do a video a day anymore because I do streams as well, but I just kept doing that. It kept me busy. Meeting people through that kept me busy. And just in sim racing in general, just talking to people and just being around people is the probably the best thing I had. I don't know. I felt like I very much dragged myself out of the hole, even though I'm still sort of in it. But people around me definitely helped me out. So if you want to come speak to people, Mickey, come do it in our Discord, man. You're always welcome. I'm a monkey, yes. Vincent asks, are there any motorsporting events you'd like to go to in real life? Yes. Nordschleife for 24 hours. I'd love to go to that. I would love to go to the Monaco Grand Prix as well. Just to somehow get there. Guys, donations for Monaco. I'm joking, for fuck's sake. Don't kill me. But yeah, I'd like to go to Monaco GP as well. I don't know, really. I'd like to go to an actual brand's race. There are a few I'd like to go to, but Nordschleife for 24 is definitely the main one. Tucker again, saying, how do I get into sim racing? I sort of answered that a couple of times, so I won't go into that again, but YouTube, basically, is the short answer. Mark says, what are your favourite cars? GT40, R32, Skyline, obviously. And my Mazda, not a normal MX-5, my Mazda. Do I like a new Supra?
Please, no.
I mean, I don't really like new cars, really. So no is the answer. I'm sure it'd be cool though. Desperate Meat with $2 saying Monaco. Thank you, Meat. We're going to Monaco, boys. We got the $2 dues. It's all we need. Mad Ahmed says, can you do a setup tour? If you can't or have already done it, it's okay, because I love your videos and saw your whole 12-hour Sebring live stream. Thanks, man. I'm glad you stayed for that whole thing. That's really impressive to stay for that long. I'll probably do a setup tour eventually when I tidy my room a bit. But that's about it. That's about it. I don't really want to do one now because my room's a tip and I'm a slob. And I don't want people to see that. the Goku says, how do you think your sim racing experience would affect your racing skills in real life? How much of a time difference do you think it would make on the same track and same car in sim and real life? That's a really difficult question. The only answer I can give is I have driven a single seater at Brands Hatch before, and it was in the wet and the car started to step out coming out of Druids, and instinctively I corrected the car because of sim racing, I think. I don't think I would have been able to save that if I hadn't been sim racing. As to how fast I'd be on the track, it's very hard to say. I would like to think I'd be okay, but I think that's more of an ego thing than anything else. I also think that in real life I'd be quite scared, because cars are scary when you go fast, but I would love to find out. If anyone's watching this who can make it happen, make it happen. Don't put Slap in a bloody Civic, put me in a Civic. I'm joking. Good on you, Slap. Alex O says, Miata? Yes. I don't really have a question. Answer
please,
to that.
No Punterino, Jimmer.
Oh, shit, John. Thank you for $25, man. Thank you, dude. Just congrats, Jimmer, on 70K. I've watched you for about 3 years, and you are a humble YouTuber. This all-round great guy. If I ever make it over to a neck of the woods, we will have to meet up for a pint. That we will, man. And I think I owe you the pint there, man. But thank you so much for the $25, dude. And thank you for the really kind words. I try and stay like not an arsehole. I think being an arsehole will be bad. But I know you guys would tell me if I would. So that's why you're all so great. But thank you, man, for the 25 and the support you've shown me through these 3 years. It's been rad. It's been great. Thank you, man. Colin Bond asks, will you cut your hair? Probably, eventually. There's no statement I'm making with this hair. I just am lazy. I'll cut it when I can't be bothered to go and do it. That's basically it. Super Fried Dumpling says, opinion on sim racing setup upgrades that really help you add speed after hours of practicing, of course. Thanks for all the content, Jimbo. I don't think anything really adds speed. I think equipment helps you get to that speed quicker. So what I would say is, like, the best thing you can probably get is a good set of pedals. They help you be more consistent in braking and acceleration. And I think that's more important than having a really good steering wheel. So I say invest a decent set of pedals. They won't make you faster. They'll make you able to go your maximum speed more often. Hope that makes sense. Alex says, I thought you won 1 million subs, but my question is, what is best budget wheel? Sorry for my bad English. Don't worry, man. Your English is probably better than my, whatever your language is. I'm going to guess German, maybe, by your name? Not sure. Best budget wheel, DFGT. Easy. Easy question. Excuse me. Pure Axel says, I was wondering what sim in your opinion has the best AI and what do you think about iRacing AI thing you're doing? Oh, I like your vids, by the way. Thank you, man. Thank you for liking my videos. Very nice of you. I think Raceroom has the best AI, followed by RF2. After that is a big gap. iRacing AI are sort of good. There's no need for it, really, given that iRacing has always been and pretty much will always be an online-focused sim. I don't really understand why they need AI. Simply, they could probably put their efforts into something else. I remember them saying like, "Oh, but it's, you know, it's a team doing this in their own time," sort of things. Like, well, in their own time, they could be fucking doing daylight transitions, couldn't they? That argument doesn't work. But yeah, Raceroom and RF2, I think. Bit loud music. I love this animation, by the way. It gets me wet. Will I do another track day event? I've not done one yet, Hilltoe, but I do plan on doing a track day of the Mazda at some point. DFGT, man. DFGT is a good wheel to start with. I'm going to do one soon, Hilltoe. Congrats, Jimmet, says Jennifer. Thanks, man. I'm wondering, how do you figure out wheel settings? Me being a TMX peasant, needing all the help I can get because British cars is nearly undrivable.
Please, Punterino, Jimmer.
Oh, fuck. Hello, Ben. Hello again, mate. Jesus, Ben. Ben coming in with $20 saying, Jimmer, GT40, best car. Yeah, goddamn right. You're goddamn right. Thank you so much, Ben, for $20. You've been giving me a lot of support recently, and it's not gone unnoticed. So thank you very much, man. Really appreciated. Meat saying you should play Police Norse. Oh, Lorraine. Good old Lorraine. But thank you, Ben. Montana asks... Oh, sorry, I didn't answer this question, Jennifer. I'm going to just skip and leave you to it. The best bet would be go to like Google and just type in TMX Project Cars 2 settings or TMX Project Cars settings, and someone's probably gone through it already. That's how I start and I tweak from there. But it's just a matter of poking and prodding. Please, until you get the right settings.
No, Jimmer.
Thank you, Toby. It says, hi ho, Jimmer. Poke, poke, poke Jimmy in the arse. Remember to eat fast, drive hard. What? You're right, Toby. You mean drinking, mate? Thank you, Toby, for the $4.99. Joe's saying his dollar didn't pop up. Oh, it is there. Thank you, Joe, for the pound. I didn't see that come up, mate. I don't know why that didn't pop up, but thank you, dude. It is appreciated. I'm not quite sure why it didn't appear. But thank you, man. Montana Phoenix asks, can I do some challenges? If I can think of them, or if you want to give them to me, feel free. I'll have a go. If they aren't stupid and clickbaity as fuck, I'll do them. He says, doing 100% full seatback challenge. Hey guys, Jimmy here, and welcome back to my stupid ass challenge. If you can think of any, let me know, and I'll think about doing them. He says, can I start the video? No. Oopsie. One AA Smurf says, thanks for the entertainment, Jimmy. Been watching since around the time of Duty 3. If you would take an hour or two to relax and drive a car and any similar game, what would you select? That's a really, really good question. I would take the Shelby Daytona Coupe in Test Drive Unlimited 1, and I would do a lap of the island. That would be me relaxing. That would be me relaxing, I think. That's a really fun thing to do. But yeah. That I used to love just slapping that island. So much fun. Physics weren't great, but you just drove around at 50-60%, taking in the scenery, overtaking fucking plebs. Great fun. DMJS asks, congrats mate, you may have answered this one before. What's your favourite racetrack in the world? Probably Spa. Spa in an LMP1. Oh, yeah. Or Le Mans in LMP1. Basically, either of those tracks in LMP1, just completely erect the entire time round. It's so much fun. There's a reason why I drive there so often, you know. It's because it's good. No question here from Samuel, but he says, grats on the 70k. Been a subscriber since 5k. That's a long time ago, so thank you, man, for sticking around for so long. Very much appreciate it. We're nearly at the end here. We're nearly at the end, chat. We nearly did it. Demolition Man says, where the hell can I get some merch? Keep going, Jimmer. There should be a merch link below in the description. If not, come over to our Facebook page and check that out. There's a merch link there. We don't really do many good things, but there is some shit there. There is some shit there, so it's good. It's a good. Nothing there from Jacob, but say congrats, thank you, man. And Apollo, any tips to be good at sim racing and be sponsored like you, Senpai? Sim racing, I just say practice. To be sponsored, I don't know, have a loud mouth, fucking chat shit a lot. I just don't know why I'm sponsored. I'm just very, very thankful that I am, hoping that my sponsors don't hate me. Yeah, we need to do a Please the Punterino sticker, you're right. But hopefully that helps out Apollo. Now, I know there are a couple more. That's all the questions there. Well, I did see Sam answer a question once about a mod alignment chart. No, Sam, we aren't doing that. I know there are a couple more as well that came in. You see, thought when we started. I do have a PS4 Felix, but I'm not going to be doing Project Cars 2 on it. Advice I give to young sim racers like you is enjoy yourself. Don't get too in. Jimmy's reserved 10 hours. Don't get too obsessed with results. Just enjoy the driving. Sean says, what's your favourite racing game of all time? Ridge Racer Type 4, I think. Ah, Miroslav says, what would you change in iRacing? The damage model was the main thing. The main thing is the damage model. It needs to be better. You can't have a game. See, look! Hold me. You can't have a... a game where you have mild damage in an endurance race, and then you have to carry that damage for the rest of the race, and there's just no possibility of repair. Especially if it's like a car that can just have like its front end repaired or switched out. So that's what I'd say. How long have I spent on sim racing games? Thousands of hours, I don't know. I think this is probably the last one before we get into this the next stuff here. What are some of your favourites in movies and music? I don't really watch any movies, Michael, frankly. I'm not a movie person. I can't sit down for that long. I get too, like I am now, a bit too bouncy, and I don't really... I watch some TV series, though. I really like BoJack. BoJack is probably my favourite recent series I've watched. And music, you'll listen to it. Synthwave. Synthwave is best wave. I'm now very tempted to click this.
Hey guys, Jimmy here, and welcome to the answer section.
Oh man, look. Do you want to hear how much I've come on in terms of like speaking?
5,000 subscriber Q&A video. Hey guys, Jimmy here, and welcome to the answer section of my 5,000 subscriber Q&A video thing type whatever. Loads of questions came in, so I'm going to sort of do it in this sort of live-ish format where I'm just going to go through them. I'll cut it up a little bit, but it's not going to be super edited, just me sort of going through the questions here. As you can see in the background,
I've got my old channel logo
open, like a big ass zoom, like 200% zoom, so you guys can see.
Oh, that red dwarf as well.
The questions I see here and sort of just sort of go from there. So I'm just going to stick it on the newest first, so we get all of them, or at least try to. So, okay, let's start at the top then. ToxicRex7 Gaming says, who are your favourite F1, Le Mans, Rally and...
Man, that makes me cringe listening to that now. Such a way away. Well, that's all of that, guys. We've done all those questions now. So we're pretty much at the end of that. Oh, God. That Argo boy. So I will now be taking questions from Chatto. If you want to ask any, of course. My knob is dirty. I don't know why. I better just grasp it a bit. Thank you, John, for two. Some video type thing, whatever. That's me. I am that. Adam says, what do you think of the crew? You're certainly not part of the closed. Okay. I never liked the crew, Adam. I didn't play it that much, though. Oh my god, the question's flooding in. I'm going to try and get to them. I didn't like the crew too much. It was a difficult one. What made you and Malone start Grip TV? A fella called Wheel Damage did. Mark Hewitt. We were racing under Mark Hewitt as a streamer team or whatever. This is back when like no one streamed anything. And we asked to have our names put on the car because the livery that we ran was just a completely Wheel Damage livery. And then he said no, made a video complaining about me asking for stuff on the livery. So we said, fuck you, we'll do something else then. There you go. I am 26, V-Hawk. Best place to get a set of Corsa mods, probably race department. Mondeo is fixed, yes. Oh my god. I've gone too far. You may have some oats, of course you can, Jim. I used to be engaged, Matt. But I never had an actual ex-wife. I'm going to just go to the newest ones now, there's too many here. Do I like tortellini? It's okay. The crew is more like Test of Unlimited Dirt Free, hint hint. Yes, I would. I would probably like it quite a bit more. You know, I've never played Drive Club, so I don't know. The Jordan flag is on my wall, just there. You can't see it. Oh, shit. That reminds me, chat. It's time for an exclusive. Time for a listen to Jimmy ramble at whatever o'clock an evening exclusive. The last part of my post that I didn't get to show earlier is something from my good friend Peter from the small town of Middelfart in Denmark. Are you ready for this? Wait, I can't even see if you can see this or not, but how cool is this? tell me that isn't the best thing you've seen. It's so good. Basically, Peter is the organizer of GTR 24, and he started his own poster company recently. And he asked if I wanted to have the long boy as a poster. So I was like, yeah, definitely. You can get your own version. They're quite expensive, but for good reason, obviously. They're really nice, high quality. But I'm going to put that on the wall at some point. It's a render from Coin, and then we blew it up, and it because it's a really nice render. A really nice clear render. It actually blew up really well. It can't go right behind. It won't fit. It's too big. Signed by GNS drivers. Maybe we'll do that at the end of the GNS era. Who knows? But that's gonna go on the wall. Can't like buy one ASAP. I will find the link. That. If you want to buy one. Again, I'm not sure how much he charges for them. I know they're a little bit, though. And I've got to try and get it back in the fucking tubbo. Primitive forms of artificial intelligence we already have proved very useful. Stephen Hawking, RIP. But I think the development of full artificial intelligence could spell the end of the human race. Once humans develop artificial intelligence, it would take off on its own and redesign itself at an ever-increasing rate. Right, Car Throttle or WTF1. I mean, they're the one in the same, aren't they? Same guys. I think it's called, like, Poster Ideas? Oh, God. Give me a second, guys. Let me turn off display capture so I can go on my Facebook and try and find it. Hello, Casper. How's it going, mate? Oh, yeah, I'm into this. What the bloody hell? Peter's does so much fucking shit. It's so hard to find anything. Okay, right. No, I'm not buying one. You cheeky boy. So here it is. This is it. Although this is incorrect. But if you want to go and buy this, then you can. The link is there. Am I John Wick stunt driving double? If only, man. I get paid a lot better. Adam says, I've wondered for a while, but I didn't want to mention it, but I've seen you wearing a necklace with a ring on it. Can I assume that's the ring that never made it far enough? No. This ring belongs to, belonged to my father. Actually, it was his engagement ring. But unfortunately, he's no longer with us, so I wear it as a keepsake. I did actually offer this to the lucky lady as an engagement ring, but she turned it down. Because she knew what it was. Come on, But yeah, not quite. But it is still a thing that I hold dearly. You like a long vehicle at the front? Yeah, check that out. Not bad, DM. We answered your question just now. I don't know if you saw it or not, man. Going back to the pad. Oh my god. Maybe I'll do it soon. Maybe you should send me. That'd be a good video, trying to do a gamepad. It could be fun to try and do that, couldn't it? I plan to, Dan Lee. I plan to. Yeah, we're just doing the last part of the Q&A, so we're just sort of having a very chill session now where we're just having a bit of an AMA and then we'll leave it at that. Been a bit of a weird day today, streaming-wise. I've not really done anything particularly well. Just sort of... Oh, sorry, I didn't see the end. Volunteer to say hi. Oh, yeah! Rollerblader, I would be all about that, man. If you wanted me to come drive and jump car, I'd fucking love it. It'll be great fun. And it'll be a great video as well. But if you're all serious about that, man, hit me up on Discord or something and we'll talk about it. Oh, the ultimate sim. Okay, well, you got your multiplayer from iRacing, your physics from RF2, your AI from RaceRoom, your just general car selection and everything being decent from Assetto Corsa, and then just like the range of weird and wacky from AMS. And the weather effects and looks from Project Cars 2. What have I done? I think you've wrecked the website. I'm going to be commentating at the GTR 24. I did say, however, I'm going to be trying to do a stint with somebody just so I can sort of say I've done a stint there. But I'm going to be commentating this year. We've got a great team this year. Yeah, guys, do you want an exclusive? Do you want an exclusive? Do you want an exclusive from GTR 24? Something that is... made me the most erect I've ever been in my life. My co-commentators, first of all, Nick Newcomb, who's a fucking bae, and secondly, my second co-commentator, the one, the only, Boily. We taking Boily to Denmark, boys! Hey, Abarimus, good to see you, man. But it's gonna be rad. Oh, not Big Bird, sad. Oh, Paul, this is the website. I just showed a poster on stream that they've sent me a poster. Of the DTRLM, it's massive. It's like it's gonna go up on my wall, but it's a site run by the guy who runs DTR24. Ugh. Be wordy, Boily. Divorced, yeah. I'll get you in the airport. Oh, Casper. Kidnapped by Casper at the airport. The dream. We'll give Boily a stint. But you wouldn't give me a stint, would you, Shane? What's that about, fam? I know why he would give Boily a stint and not me a stint. Adam asked, do I have any regrets for my YouTube sim racing career? I regret not trying to work on my anger sooner. I used to be quite arrogant. I used to think that I was right a lot of the time. And now I sort of look back at it and go, Jesus Christ, you're a wanker. So I regret not doing that too much. Apart from that, no, not really. This is all very new to me. I've not had time to really have regrets. So no regrets. I don't know, Joe. I don't know, mate. I don't know. I'm still thinking about it. But yeah, I encourage you guys, even if you're only going to go as spectators, to go to the GTR 24, because it is like nothing else you've ever experienced. I've got Shane here in chat, actually last year's P1 winner, or P2 winner, sorry. He'll tell you how great GTR 24 is. Such a cool experience. And I hear that Nicky Team might be there. Might be there. That's not confirmed, but I'm hearing stuff. I'm hearing that he might be there. Side taskbar friends, yeah! The best of friends. Team versus Bailey. Well, the thing you say that, Joe, I heard from a very reliable source about Team versus Bailey. Now, remember, this is highly, and I'm talking like the most confidential stuff we've got on this channel. If I can find the goddamn picture, because I have so many fucking pictures now on my hard drive that I've lost it all. It was a very interesting rumor actually about Boyle and Bailey, and that's this, you know. Very classified, extremely classified. Although saying that, the sad boys about that is Bailey won't be able to join us tomorrow. He's busy, so we've got Coin instead. No, I'm looking forward to driving with Coin. It's been a while. Boyle and Bailey. I'm liking that. I guess we should probably round this off, guys. I don't want to sit here and blabber too much. But do we have any more questions I can help you out with? Worst car ever present in a sanctioned race series? Jesus. I can't answer that. There are so many bad ones. AGS is pretty bad. In F1, wasn't it? Otherwise, I don't know. Am I going to visit that croissant? Yes, I am. Fuck off. My croissant. Who is my favourite YouTuber? Chugga Conroy. Although I don't really watch him much anymore. He's just so happy. I'm sure I could be that happy. I'm good, Mr. Wasim. Thank you. Retro Sunday will be this week. Yes. Don't know what I'm doing yet, but we'll work it out. I would take the Corvette, I think. Actually, no, the Ford GT LM. If you mean the most recent GT, then yes, that one over the Corvette. Veronica's gone back to Spain, where she lives. Cool. I think Hamilton will win the World Championship this year. I still love Ted. He is definitely my son. Don't worry. Ted will always be my son. What happened to your Nicky Team? It's still there. It just doesn't work. I'm going to try and put it back into back in soon. Favorite video from the last year? Probably Nicky Team's Le Mans insider thing. That was really cool. I can't film time with Jim Jam because I can't get it up anymore, Johannes. Someone who lost his job and recently wants to try YouTubing is don't expect to be paid in the first year, Alex. And do it because you want to do it, pretty much. Favorite Groupie rally car would probably be the 6R4, because it is best box. What, when, how long is the race tomorrow? Okayama, GT3, 3 hours, 7 o'clock or so, around then. Never been to Australia, but I would like to. Oh, I get to stay on your fold out. Oh, yeah. Retro D, yes. Yeah, Retro D? No, initial D. Reading stuff at the same time, sad. I will stream GT4 when I can be bothered to do it again. I don't know who will win Le Mans 2018. Not Toyota, because lol. It won't be a very long stream, Metal Mike. It's only about an hour to do that. Stream tomorrow will probably be about... We start about half six, low streams. So I get a bit of pracky in, so... I can always feel love, Freddy. How come you and Nikki are BFFs? Because we both have really cool hair. That's why. No worries, Mr. Wasim. I'm glad we can do that for you, man. You'll always have friends in this channel. I love you very much. You are the best, Chatto. But guys, I think I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to leave off the stream there. We're going to be back tomorrow with actual sim racing as opposed to me just sitting here and rambling away. If you've enjoyed the Q&A, hit the like button, maybe subscribe as well, etc. Got some cool stuff coming tomorrow and some cool videos planned. So make sure you stick around. And yeah, hopefully I'll be doing some Red Bull stuff next week, if I'm lucky. If I'm lucky, probably not. But catch you later, taters. Love you very much, Lee. Y'all be good now. Favorite suit, Group C car is 962. Goodbye!